This episode of Tutcast is brought to you by GDIformoms.com. Visit today and let them help you build a better business, not only for yourself, but by yourself. GDIformoms.com. Hey there, welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Tutcast.com. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to take a standard photo and give it a retro style comic book effect. Now this video tutorial is based off of a written tutorial which can be found at photoshoproadmap.com. So let's get started. So we're going to take this photo, and the first thing we're going to do, we're going to adjust some levels to sharpen up a few aspects of the photo. And to do that, we're going to go to Image, Adjustments, and then Levels. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab my far left slider, which controls the shadows of our image, and drag it to the right just to sharpen up those shadows. I'm then going to grab my right slider and drag it to the left to increase the highlights just a little bit, just like that. And then click OK. What we're going to do now, we're going to give it sort of an older feel by adding some film grain. And to do that, we're going to go to Filter, Artistic, and then Film Grain. And in a second, our film grain dialog box will appear. Here we go. And I'm going to use these settings, 4, 0, and 10. Now, depending on your image, the settings may vary depending on how much highlights and how much shadows you have in your image. But basically, you're going for this sort of look, sort of a grainy look that separates the shadows and the highlights, just like you see in this area here. And when you're happy with the result, click on OK. Now what we're going to do now, we're going to duplicate this layer. So going over to our layers palette, as you can see here, I have my background layer. So I'm going to double click on this, click OK to make it a separate layer, and then drag it down to the bottom to our new layer icon, which will duplicate that layer. What I'm going to do now, we're going to give it that halftone pop art effect by going to Filter, Pixelate, and then Color Halftone right there. And here's our color halftone dialog box. And the only setting you should change is this one right here, the first one. Max radius, we're going to set to 4 pixels. Now, obviously, depending on your personal preference, you can play around with the settings and you'll have different results. We're going to click OK. And right off the bat, it looks sort of comic-y, but it looks a little bit too bright. So what we're going to do in our layers palette, once again, selecting the top layer that we just added the halftone to, we're going to click on the blending options right here and select darken. And you'll notice we now have a nice comic book effect on our photo. And that's basically it. Again, you can change the settings based on your personal preference and depending on the type of image you have, how much highlights, how much shadows you have. Very, very simple. Check out the original at photoshoproadmap.com. Also, head over to tutcast.com for more Photoshop tutorials in higher quality. So until next time, this is Howard from tutcast.com. Take care.